In the last lecture, we looked at overloading in concept in Java, where we looked at how we can achieve overloading by passing different number of parameters, changing the data type that we are using. Today, we are looking at another concept in the OOPS concept, whereby we are looking at overriding. In overriding, there is a lot of issues that we need to understand first. Let's look at a certain example. We have a parent class. A parent class has a certain method, like let's say it's a farmer. It's a farmer. A farmer has got a certain property. The property consists of something like plot and what? And fish pond. In overriding, methods from the parent are inherited to the child. So the concept is when parent methods are inherited from the parent to the child. This symbol is like a concept whereby we have got a farmer who owns properties. This farm have got children or sons. These sons by default owns a farm. Why? Because they inherit from their parent. So this one is one of the methods in a parent class being property. Let's say there are two methods. One is property method. The second one is, let's say, machinery method. Public in this machinery method, the farm owns something like a farm, something like, not a farm as such, let's say pump and tractor. These are machinery, pump and tractor. Owns farm and tractor. Now, if in a parent, we have property, we have machinery. Let's say a child of this parent is now inheriting from a parent. Now, let's create another class. Being a child of this parent, let's call it child. This extends, use extends keyword, extends parent. Here, the concept of overloading might say the parent has defined certain methods or certain properties here, but the child might be not interested in the way in which these methods were implemented. Let's say the parent owns property. In property, the parents owns plot and fish pond, but a child might say, no, I don't want to own a property, farm and fish pond. Let me own something else. So he can redefine the same property method in its own way. So let me go on to say public. This is the property. Now, redefined on his own way, saying, I want to own something like it. Now I want a farm. Instead of having plot and fish, I want my property to be consist of a farm. Again, now, let's try to bring in the main and try to understand how methods are being resolved based on this concept of overriding and this concept of overriding. Let's try to create a certain object. Like, let's first of all create a parent object, PR. Right. Now, PR. Dot. No, here we are supposed to bring in the main, the main here, so that we are able to call some of the methods from the classes. Now, PR dot, now we are able to have access to those machinery. Now we have access to machinery dot. I'll explain property. Now, what are the outputs that we are supposed, we are expecting to have here? Now, here we are definitely everything is coming from the parent class. So we are expecting to have something like machinery. Then the machinery method is supposed to give us an output here. This is the output from the machinery class. This is what we expect to see. From this, is why? Because it's being referencing the parent class. We expect to have plot and what? And fish pond. Now, let's look at the parent and at the child class now. Child. CH. Child. Now, CH. Dot. CH. Now, in the child class, we might not have our machinery method clearly or explicitly defined here, but it's by default there because it's already declared in the parent class. Now, we are going to have our parent, our machinery here, having output of saying pump and tractor. This is the output here. Now here, because it's the child class redefined, its own method of property, we are expecting this one because of overriding. The method in the parent have been overridden. So we are expecting to have something like a farm here. Now let's go on to another one which need also to take care. Yeah, parent reference is being used to hold child object, but we cannot use the reference to call child specific methods. Only methods available in the parent we can call. So here we must understand the function of the JVM and the function of the compiler. First of all, the JVM will check whether there is a method. We will check the methods that are available in the parent class, which is property and machinery. If there is no any other method, we are not able to call any child specific method. So if we try to call, let's say PTR dot, we are only able to call only methods that are available in the parent, that is property and machinery, because we are not able to call child specific methods. That's the function of the compiler here. PTR dot, then we can choose property. Now, why? Because property is a parent-specific method. But during the runtime, the JVM will check if the parent, if the parent object, if it is the parent object, if not, and check if it's overriding. If it is overriding, it takes the child specific method. In overriding, method resolution is based on runtime object. That's the reason why overriding is being called runtime polymorphism. That's the reason why we call overriding runtime polymorphism or dynamic polymorphism or late binding. The difference between overriding and overloading when in method resolution is, in overriding, method resolution is taken care by the JVM based on runtime objects. Thus, when we are dealing with overriding, in overloading, method resolution is taken care by compiler based on a reference type. That's the reason why overloading is called compile time polymorphism. Compile time polymorphism or early binding. Now, here, because it's runtime polymorphism or late binding or dynamic binding, method resolution is based on runtime object being the child class here. The method that is going to be taken is property from the child. So we are expecting an output. Output something like farm. Let's try to compile and find out what is going to be the output. Now let's look at the console and find out what is going to be the output. Right, that is the output now. We have farm, plot, pump, tractor, plot, and fish, pump, tractor, farm, and farm, which we expect to have on the console. Now, what we can do now is try to understand what is the function of the JVM and the function of the compiler when resolving the method in overloading and overriding. If we understand that concept, it will become very simple and clear. In our next lecture, we are going to look at rules for overriding. Thanks for your time. Please don't forget to subscribe. Thank you.